was very happy to be at my community yesterday at 4:00. It was great. I turned off all the lights because I put the new curtains of the blackout curtains in the living room, so it was nice and dark. I turned off all the lights and we'll see how I feel. Actually, it's going to depend on my back. Buddy was like, yeah, I'm not getting in that van. I'm not going. So I had to just front legs up, and he's like, and while after his front legs go in, I'm trying to quickly lift up his. He's like, oh, you're back there? Oh, okay. Well, I'm gonna, my front legs are gonna back up. Yeah. So it was not the best positioning to be lifting that much. And I didn't think anything of it Thursdays, but then I had a lift her up and give her in again.
She's low, too.
Yeah, so by Friday night.
And well, maybe it's from the furniture. I didn't even think about these dogs.
Yeah, well, but on Friday, on Thursday, well, but you know what? I agree with that. But one of my buddies adopted Mola. Excuse me. That's her favorite. What's wrong, Lex? So their dog before the ginger, their dog before they got Nola, their third dog passed, and he's like become the doctor. So she has all this guilt that she wasn't there. So I'm like, I can see where like you have that too. Like at least when you have to do it,
you're there.
So and I because I always thought, well, that would just be this. They could just move off. And that's that he was programmed that they just fall asleep. But she has this guilt that she wasn't there when it happened. So I guess I don't think it's. I think it's all the inbreeding they do with that breed. I really do. He was nuts.
So strong. He was super strong.
Yeah. And he was 96 pounds when he died. He died standing up. He wouldn't lay down. They sedated him. I remember she had the stethoscope right here in his heart. She looks up underneath because I'm on the other side. She looks up and he's gone. And here he was. Just on all fours.
Yeah, this guy's a registered Dalmatian. So broad.
Mm-hmm. Oh yeah, he had the legs of like a pity or something.
Yeah,
small.
Yeah.
How long
was
that?
All that
thing. Oh wow. Okay, that's ridiculous. I didn't want the fourth one.
Talking about you, Leo.
Uh-huh. Oh, everybody went, oh, he loves you. Yeah, uh-huh.
everybody's like, oh, he's Chelsea. I'm like, I'm not choosing him. I'm not taking home another dog. But his situation was that he was with a foster. No slip collar, no slip lead, sorry. Just the yellow one on the harness.
Yeah,
so she apparently is such a puller at the shelter, she's done some damage to her training.
Yeah.
We didn't know if she was getting kennel cough. They checked her out, it's not. She's actually done some damage. I don't know. Gonna have a conversation. Gonna have a conversation with the clinic later. I want them to, because she's got a lump on her back left hip. I don't know if that has anything to do with why she's not consistently bearing weight on that leg or not. So they need to check it out. Maybe it's her.
It could be. She's been through that.
Okay, maybe it's her.
She doesn't need really this sort of thing normally.
No, I think it's her. Okay. She definitely
got
this.
Yeah.
But you need a dog.
A dirty stinky dog.
You know, actually,
are you guys okay?
Do you remember the dog's name?
No.
What did he look like?
I wonder whether that was some that was just trying to get taken out.
That's Lexi. She's only been with us for about a week and a half. Most likely either from us or from the shelter.
It almost looked like that dog.
That used to be there.
Yeah.
Oh, really?
That's how that dog had looked. Yes, I remember.
So I can come in anytime and sit with dogs, right? Because
that's not the same dog.
You sure can.
All right. Sounds good.
Wow.
What time?
11 to 3.
Thursday through Sunday.
Now just so you know, next week, from Saturday, from Christmas Eve next weekend through to July, from the 24th through the 4th of January will be closed, and then we open again on Thursday or today.
Okay.
So for the next,
somebody comes in and stays with them though.
No, they go
they
back
go
to
back
the
back
shelter
back.
Each night.
Oh, they do.
Yeah, we
oh.
transport them back and forth.
Fine, I'll see you later.
All right.
Yep. Absolutely. Take care of these dogs.
Well, Kaylin, she is, she's got you free.
Right where you should want to.
It's like, you just sit there and rub my belly all day. She's rubbing it, she rolls all day.
He's my medical counselor. He has to be tough. Pretty significant separation. I've never had, I've had dogs my whole life. I've never had a dog with anything that I would recognize as this is the behavior.
Okay.
I take him out at little meetings, the very last minute, maybe as far as he can meet.
Yeah.
And I come back and talk to him. And he won't be easy, he's saying. But. You're sure if you're adopted.
Are we mentioning now that you need?
It can be a real challenge. Like, I know, I have always known that it was a thing, but I've never personally experienced it. It's very stressful.
Yeah.
It really is. And he hurts himself.
Yeah, he uses all the back.
But he actually really uses himself.
We saw you before, your little hound dog crying away.
You can say hi to other people, it's fine. Yep, that's exactly.
Do you eat chicken?
Little tiny slices because she's got an upset tummy.
Yeah.
Yeah. So little tiny just feathers. But that's good enough for her, so.
Okay, I'll be right back.
everybody else is out right now, but thank you very much.
Fatten you up. We do. We fatten you up.